But now the important thing is this. Just because I have given you one example where greedy works extremely well, doesn't mean that this algorithm will perform well on any network. We haven't yet proven that it has a good approximation quality. And a good way to test approximation quality is to always try and construct an input for which the algorithm will perform really, really bad. So basically, we're now going to try and trick this algorithm here, the greedy algorithm, into picking suboptimal vertices, basically using this greedy strategy against it. And if we do this, basically using this greedy strategy against it, and that will give us some indication on where this algorithm could fail and how badly it could fail. So if it's a factor 2 approximation algorithm, if it's a factor 1.5 approximation algorithm maybe, or if it's actually not a good approximation algorithm at all, although it sounds good. And of course, this is similar to some of the problems we have already had in this course. Finding out how to trick this algorithm, that takes a bit of playing around. So next to the screen here, I have lying about 4 or 5 sheets of paper on which I experimented around to find out how I could trick this algorithm. And whenever you want to trick an approximation algorithm, it just takes a bit of time to sink your teeth into that. But here's something that I have come up with, and it's very similar, of course, to the ideas that other people have also had to try and trick the greedy algorithm. So I'll start out with the amazing number of 24 vertices. Now, as if this weren't enough, I will now add 12 additional vertices. You can now see why I used up so much paper playing around with this. And I'm going to connect them like this. Now, my question to you is, how many vertices would greedy choose if we gave it this graph here as an input? And please enter your answer here.